Hello everybody and welcome once again to Beyond Galactic Science. We've got a few things to do today, so I'm going to get straight on with them. First thing we're going to have a look at is TARDIS blocks and this transmat thing. Phew. This is a roundel, and on the roundel I've put a transmat interface, and you right click this with the thing, so it's set now to this point, and if I set it back it's a default location. So I'm going to set it here, and I'll show you what it does when I set it to here. If I now change the screwdriver to transmat mode and right click, then we appear there. So for the time being, this is a pretty good thing to do, I think. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to quickly craft some TARDIS blocks. Now, TARDIS blocks are simply chrono steel surrounded by smooth stone, like that. We get these TARDIS blocks. With these TARDIS blocks, you can then change those shape like that. And you can change them to the different ones, solid planks, and then the last one will be flat blocks like this. You can't do it like this. If I put this, for example, this one down here like that, that's the standard block with the beveled edges. If I now go and take the decorator and change this, look at this one, then press, this is now set to smooth blocks. If I left click this, doesn't do anything, just tries to destroy it a bit. So now break that. Now the only way to do that, therefore, is to craft it. But you can do self-crafting, so it's no big deal. So now it's so we'll put it down here like this. So now it should be in a different one. What have we got? Solid block. Oh, I thought it was already solid blocks. Try it again. Solid bricks. Like this. So you get your brick layout. The next one along is, that must have been a flat block before. Is the planks. So he looks like that, and he looks like planks. And then the last one should be smooth, flat block, like this. So put this down, and it should not have any edges on it, like that. So that's what you can do with those. And then you can go along here, and we're going to have a look at my farm again. I've had a problem with my farm. It's not working as I expected it to do. It's not the farm that's not working as I expected, it's here where I've got a problem with these interfaces. At the moment I had to add sort of one at the bottom to extract stuff, and it's a bit difficult to reach, so we need to take the Yetta wrench here, and then we press shift left click on here, then we should get the interface. Oops, just the wrong one. Fantastic. Right, that's a good example. Let's do let's just move this out of the way. I don't need this for the time being. So here's the item conduit again. Let's just put that back if I can reach, which is quite awkward here, I think. Yes, it is quite awkward. Let's go a little bit back, see if I can reach it from there. We go. So I can put it back here. So then I can shift left click with the, I'm in the wrong mode at the moment. So we'll just change that to the right mode. Or we can actually see the pipes like this. And then shift left click that. And then we get the interface. So I actually wanted it on the blue channel as an extract mode, because then it's the output one, which is always active, like this. And then you can just come back a little bit more. We can then see it here like that. So the blue channel was coming down and then out into the base, as it were, into these, really, these cable interfaces. The item cable interfaces may be the ones that actually store the items. It's got two chests worth of items it's storing. That does sort of make sense, but it was not behaving the way it does in the other farm, and neither does this. This is actually quite interesting. You see here, I put some TARDIS blocks. Now, that's what I was going to do with the other ones. I was going to put them down like this, simply right clicking them into position. Oh, I didn't actually do an auto refill on that one. Ah, because of course I'm not. That's strange. I thought I had done that actually. Seem to have gone back to the wrong one. Let's break that up like that. Then we'll do the others. I'll move that out of the way. Solid bricks. It says, "Oh, that's solid brick." No, it's the same. But this time it did change it to okay. Flat blocks, that's the one I wanted, like this. And I was just filling in this area with sort of flat blocks. In fact, I've been changing my mind about this. I'm not happy with it. There's a lot of flat blocks in this big chamber, so what I'm thinking of doing is to create a new room schema. I don't think I'm going to get time to do that in this episode, but maybe we can do that in the next episode. You see, you can fill it all in like this. You can come along here and change. You can put it on top of this as well, for that matter. It doesn't make it, you can't then see the roundels. You can always change the roundels anyway, so it's no big deal. Like that. Looks a bit messy. I'm going to dig up these other blocks and convert those to flat blocks as well. Now, the farm here is always running out of axes. So I'll right click this. At the moment, we've just got an axe in it. But I don't. That's interesting. I don't think they're actually getting automatically refilled. It didn't seem to be the case. And I know it chops down a lot of loses a lot of saplings, but I think that's a progressive automation thing, where the saplings drop and they're not getting picked up by the wood chopper. Some of them are, some of them aren't. Just don't quite know how that works. So I'm just having a look around here, seeing whether it does actually replace an axe. We'll still see in a few seconds, because this one's going to get broken in a very short period of time. In fact, it should be broken by the time it does these four trees, or eight trees. And what I want to do here is to watch what's going on, because I've got a feeling that the axe is in here. And we expect to see another axe when that one breaks. Come out of here and then go into this mini chest here. It's a good question as to when it's going to break, of course. In fact, I would have expected to have broken already. It looks like it's broken because the trees are not getting chopped down anymore. Let's go and have a quick look. Let's see. Like this. Yes, the axe is broken. It's got a slight problem with this as well. I want to show you back in the actual base, the moon base, what's actually happening there, because that's working completely differently. So I'm going to have to try and figure this out, which I will do, and then when I've figured it out, I'll come back again. I can't get through that door like that. Let's just take the... don't want to be transmit mode just at the moment. I'll just set that to reconfigure mode. Now the farm's over here. I'm just picking up a load of stuff, saplings of course. And the entrance to that is down here somewhere. I can actually get into it, I think. I haven't covered it up, that is. Actually, I don't know where I get into it now. It might be able to get it from the actual right from the very from the base, but anyway, the entrance is down here. So let's just go down here. Break this little bit over here, so I'll change this block now and put back the excavator like this. Oh yes, you can get to it from there. Oh no. So this basically just runs around here. And on all of the farms, so I'll just change this, make sure I don't hit them, is if I look at this item here, you see it's just set to input output, so inserting on the brown and extracting on the green. And maybe it's a good idea to do that then. Okay, that's probably what I should have been doing. These are the four farms you can see at the top there. They'll all be the same, otherwise it wouldn't work at all. Okay, let's quickly whip back to the TARDIS. And come down here. So actually that's what I'm actually doing, aren't I? I'm actually extracting on the blue and inserting on the green. Well, let's change this around a bit. Let's change this to insert on the blue channel. And that's inserting. And this one down here, we shall reverse those two. So we'll insert on the green channel and extract on the blue channel like that, and that should be the same. So what we need to then just do is to come over here and get reach this one, which I'll have to use with the Yetta wrench and shift left click it, because I can't do it otherwise. So we want to extract on the green channel, and then we come along here and we simply set this one here to be the same, so it's blue on these sides. In fact, I'll have to do this one as well. Let's do that one first of all. Extracting on the green, and that's just an extract mode. So that's basically pulling the... It is wood, isn't it? Yes. And I'm going to have to shift left click again. Oh no, I can hit this one on the top here. One of the reasons for using the mini chests as well. They don't hold that many items. So you never get... you don't get overwhelmed with them. So we now need to... on the wrong way. Insert on the green channel, and then the reverse on this one, because this is going to be, that's brown, that's fantastic, and this one we want to reverse. So let's have a look, see if that actually then works. I don't see it will make much difference actually. Like that. So then this should insert on the blue channel. So it should get its axe. But it doesn't seem to be working. Stone axes are whitelisted. Like that. Just to make sure. They're exactly the same. What's this number here? Do I have to just press it 1 and get that to insert? Nope, it's still using the same. Oh, it's still using the same axe. We could also do. So we'll quickly go back and craft some more item conduits in cable interfaces. So the one we want is, let's go back here and type. And we want the item interface item duct here. That's just 4 gold nuggets and some chests and some iron ingots. No big deal, we've got plenty of iron ingots here. I've seemed to get a lot of copy runners. I've got 14 gold nuggets. We need 4 for each one. I want to make 4, so we'll need 16. I'll take another gold ingot like that. And we've got 8 chests, so we'll make as many as we can. 4. Exactly. Well, actually, we'll make some more chests while I'm thinking about it, because I've got any wood in there. Yes, I have got plenty of wood in here. I want to test something out. And I also need a filter. Let's make a filter. So we need paper, 4 paper. We need another chest, because we need to make a hopper. Like that. And then we put the hopper and we do a plus of paper. And then we get the item filter. So what I was planning to do with this now is to see if we are actually extracting different things from here. See, it's not chopping anymore, so that means it has definitely broken the axe, and the axe has not been replaced. And that I don't fully understand. Obviously, there's no place for the wood to go at the moment, so we'll create a new filter here. I'll link that into some of these. Let's put a chest down here, for example. Here's a good place, I reckon. What do you know? And then we'll take off the here, so we'll reconfigure this. Let's go back to reconfigure mode. That's blue, I know that for the strangely enough, I can remember the colours of this quite easily. And we'll take an item filter here and put that on there like that, and then I'm going to put into here, where has it gone to? I haven't got any with me at the moment. Have I got any in my bag? Nope, not in there. Oops. Well, don't think I've got one in here either. I have to go back and get one quickly. I need some more item ducks. I'll take those with us, actually. A shame I can't transmit to the other place quickly like I could. Probably be moving the stuff over here might be a sensible thing to do, actually. At least we'll have something, a workbench while I'm working. So, now we are producing axes on the blue channel. Is that correct? Yes. So this is outputting on the green channel here. Just see it here like this. Double check that, you'll see it's got no axes in there. And then, so we want the green channel coming out of here. And all I'm going to do here is I'm going to set a filter up here like this, extracting. And I'm going to say I would like to have some, what do we want to have? Wood and apples, I guess. Huh? So wood I haven't got with me. Let's get some wood out of here, a piece of wood, like that. Because the only thing I can think of that's actually going wrong here is that maybe it's to do with these interfaces at the bottom here, that they probably aren't working as expected. So let's simply change the direction of this one, like that, and that should all be, that's all I need to do, is it? So look at this. I haven't changed the redstone yet. So now we're getting apples and wood in from the tree chopper over here. So we should see this disappearing out of, these should be disappearing out of here. But I don't see them moving at the moment, which is also strange. That is set to auto extract, isn't it? Let's do shift left click again. It is extracting on the green channel. So everything in here should be green. And the default output on the hot chopper is the underside. Unfortunately, this is a slight problem I've got here. I can't get these to, you can't get at the underside from here. So what I'm planning to do is to create, I said, a new room and do the same thing. Just turn that round. Well, I can do that. Didn't know that. Something new. And that's actually not taking any more. That's very strange. I don't understand how the item ducts are working in the TARDIS. But I'll have to do some research and see if I can figure it out. And of course you can dig up these blocks as well. Oh, I think I showed you that already. That's a solid block, that's a flat block. Put the flat block in here, is what I want to do anyway. Like this. Right, that's a bit of not what I wanted to do. But the next thing I'm going to do is actually have a look here. And I'm going to go, I think we'll fly to Venus today as an exercise. So open up this chest here, and I've got in it, actually I've got it here. I've got a landing, TARDIS landing pad here. I'm going to use this when we go to Venus. So the recipe for that is fairly straightforward. It's 4 chronosteel, 3 dalinicum, and 1 iron, 1 block of redstone. It's a bit expensive, but at this stage of the galactic science, there's no shortage of any of those two materials. That's that one. So it's no big deal to actually make that. There is an interesting thing. There are 2 dalinicum ingots as well. So let's have a look at that. Oops. So we've got the one here from the TARDIS mod, and the other one is the Dalek mod. And this is the one you actually need to make things like the weak blood orbs for blood magic, shape crafting, and in fact, as well as using that undesh to make the blood altar. And they're not interchangeable, so I was thinking that's a bit of a problem. So we've got to go and somehow get some of these dalinicum ingots to progress in that particular mod. So that will do in a future episode. I might even do that with my daughter, actually. Go and see if we can kill a few Daleks. So, next thing, Venus. Let's come along here and now let's click the screen so we can see that screen. I really should move Relayer out of the way, it's a bit in the way at the moment. So if I shift right click this now with the screwdriver or an open hand, so we're then in dimension IO and then it's Europa. Those are all DeCristallo. These are all, and here's Venus. Those other ones are the Dalek mod ones, not the Galactic Science dimensions, and therefore you don't need to have in them any oxygen tanks. So next thing is the X location. Iowa X minus 115. I've no idea how to find this. That's minus 207. Let's try going up a bit. I only need to be around approximately there. What we'll do is we'll put the landing pad down and then get the machine to transport itself over there. This is the Y direction, and the Y is actually high. It's 93, so that's 91. That'll be fine. This one is a Z dimension, and we need 139. Actually, that will do. I'm not going to mess around too much because we'll get it to teleport over there. Hopefully, you don't land it in anything bad. So now we're doing the usual thing. Of course, I don't need to. So yeah, travelling at 3B per tick, whatever B is, and we're already landing. So the speed, even though it's at its lowest possible setting, is still very fast. Because most of the time seems to be done in landing and taking off. Let's see if I can just get that over there and see it both times. Alright. Now we've landed, let's right click this. So we're actually obstructed. Two sides are obstructed and one isn't. So that means we've got to take off and land again, but we'll just turn the TARDIS around 180 degrees to do that. I want this one for turn type. I always get that wrong order. So now we should be at, we should be safe. Actually, I will check before we go and have a go outside the door. So the current, everything is actually safe except for two sides, which will be the two other sides. So come out of here. Oh, we've landed down underground somewhere. Ah, okay. What level are we at? Let's press F3 and have a check. We're at 88, so we're not very far from the surface. Let's just fly up here and break away out of here like this. Probably the best thing to do. It's grass, so it can't be very far away. Yes. So we're quite near to base. In fact, base where I wanted to be was around about here. We got some Venetians. Hello, Venetians. These guys don't do very much. Where is where I want to be? I want to be relatively near the Ender Farm over here. And my base underground is here, look. That's my underground base. We'll have a quick look at that in a second. First of all, I'll put down the landing pad like this. We'll have it say here, so just to get one block, and I don't want the TARDIS up one level high. And then we'll go to recall mode. Oops, I just missed it. It's the orange one. Right click that there. Oops, just right click it, and then it says the TARDIS is inbound. It should land on the on the landing mat. Perfect, look at that. Now I'm going to go into the TARDIS like this, and what I'm going to do here is I'm going to save the location. So at the moment, this location here I've actually managed to name. I'll do that in a few minutes. So that is the moon base. So if we right click that there. In fact, what we want to do is we want to set, first of all, we'll set this as, we'll save the one next one along. That's just an empty slot. So if we right click this, like this, so that's in the save mode. We want the current coordinates, like that, and we want to press button 2, and those are now saved. So I've pushed this back in again because that's really important to do that. Otherwise, if you forget, you can do this. So that should now take us to the moon. If we come over here, we should see. And this one, if we right click this now, should take us to Venus. And now you see the wire is not actually at 94, not as it was before. So we can quite safely go out of this door, hit like this. And I'll show you how to save that in a second. I was doing it right, but it just looked a bit confusing. So here was my little Venus base. So I've got an oxygen tank here. Oxygen compressor to fill up the oxygen tanks. And a teleporter here. And then I've also got a cryogenic chamber here to sleep in. Sleep through the night when I was trying to set up the Ender Farms. So I wasn't being attacked by mobs while I was trying to set up the Ender Farms. As simple as that, really. That's a bit strange. Now, there is a problem with Transmat. We have to be quite near the TARDIS. The TARDIS has to be in a loaded chunk. So let's just test this out. I'll fly over here a bit. So I press F3. I'll just check which direction I'm flying in. East. Across these buildings over here. And you see it. In Venus, there's plenty of lava pools. There aren't any dungeons or anything like that, do I? As far as I know. But they do have these as well. These are their dungeons, but there's nothing in them, just a few eggs. And actually, you can take the eggs. And you can see at the bottom of this one, we've got lava. And the lava you can just treat like basically with water, so it's not like the Nether. So we can take a bucket of water out of here, for example. Right click this like this, and then put the bucket of water, say, down. Let's put it down here, for example. And that'll then go and squidge the... Well, squidge, probably not the right word. The lava. So let's go and... I need to get rid of a bit more inventory space, so I'll move these out of the way. Like that. And you can punch these. You just, with an empty hand, you can take them. You see that? Then take them. So long as I'm doing it with an empty hand. You can't do it with itself either. I don't know what uses they are, but yet. So we drop down here like this. You'll see that some of that actually hasn't been converted. Yes, it is. Look, here we've got plenty of cobblestone. Need to land this faster, isn't it? So that's being converted. In fact, the obsidian should be over here somewhere. There we are, look. So you can quite happily, if I land on this, it'll take that as well. So let's go and fly back up here. Pick up my bucket of water again, which I've taken here, so I've got my bucket here still. Right, now, at this stage, the TARDIS should not be in a loaded chunk anymore. So let's go back to Transmat mode and right click, and it goes brrr. So that means you can't transmat back to the TARDIS because the TARDIS is too far away. But we could actually put it into a loaded chunk. You see, this is where the Ender Quarry has been, and there's basically converted all of the Venus rock into dirt, and it actually has flowers growing on it, quite nice really. So right click back this like this, and we're back in it. Now it works, you see. So let's go back to the moon. The reason I'm going back to the moon, anything else, is to be able to show you what I couldn't do before and why I didn't think I could do it. So, right, first of all, let's set the destination. Where am I? Lost in my own TARDIS, there we go. Let's right-click that one. And, oh, I've got to press this one, haven't I? I've got to press the temporal primer, first of all. Right-click that. Right-click the helmet regulator, and then right-click the quantum brake. And right-click here, and we get this destination. The XP is going up all the time as we do, even with these little flights. Now we should be simply. Oh, yes, won't open in flight because it hadn't gone bong. Right, here we are. So what I want to do here is to go and get myself a little XP. In fact, what I'm going to do is I'm going to move this anyway. This is just an XP drain with some open blocks tanks, all from open blocks, of course. Let's just, I need an empty hand for this. And I want 5 XP. So, like that. Have I got enough inventory space? Yes, I have just. So what I'm going to do is now break these. Oops, yes, I picked up, overdone the moon rock here, haven't I? Let's put that down here at number 4. And put those into place, back into place. Or should we put this one like that? There we go. And then you can take these as well. Oh, I think I do know what the problem is. That one's are not full. Okay, so I'm going to have to... let me just get some more inventory space. We'll put the target blocks out of the way. There we go. So this is an empty one. That'll need another slot. And that's the last one there, so we can put it was actually moon dirt rather than moon rock. I'll get it out of the way anyway, I don't need it in my inventory. And quickly zap back into the TARDIS. And get a piece of paper. And let's put the piece of paper into this temporal lab. That won't take a few seconds. You'll see that's working just fine, landed and everything just as I wanted it to do. And here we've got the temporal name tag. Now what I was having a problem was I put this into here like this, and it said I couldn't do it getting this across. And what I hadn't done is to actually simply type. So we need to have Venus base like that, then take it out, and it looks like there's two, but it's not, it's just a bug. So now we can come along here with this name tag, it should say Venus base on it, and simply right click this button here, which is the second one, and then it's labeled, says on the top left hand corner, slot one renamed to Venus base. So that's moon base, Venus base, as you can see in Wayland, it tells you that. So I think I right click that now, so that should be in, oh no, I didn't, I just labeled it in the Venus base, and that's the moon base. So that's how that works. Took me a while to figure that one out. I had done it before, and it was my own fault. I will be quite honest. It says it here in the library. Temporal name tags. You can, it's basically simply, okay, can be used by putting it in an anvil and right-clicking on the waypoint you want to mark it. You'll never be lost again. Fantastic, huh? That'll teach me. In fact, no, that chest was just an extract chest. That was for extracting axes, wasn't it? That's why I'm confused, because that was working. In fact, there's no reason why. Have I got an axe with me? Yes, I have. Let's just try that again. I think, actually, I changed the colour, didn't I, to blue for insertions. Oh, no, maybe it was green. Let's just put it back into green and see what happens. That is staying there. Let's change this to a different colour then. Get on the edge like that. Oh yeah, just to be very precise. So I'll say that is blue. Oh, that was a priority. And this one wants to be blue. And it's still there. Oh, okay, not surprising really. Let's put that back to green and then do the extract mode to blue. But it's still there. Strange. So I'm going to have to redesign my thoughts of what I was doing before. Yes, that should have been blue coming in on the side here. And the side is configured correctly. It should be configured to normal. We can double check that. What mode am I in? I'm in query mode. As you can see, it's going, it's flashing around the blocks here to show me what the range is. In fact, I do want to change this. So let's have a look. See, it's set to normal. Current side is set to normal, which is correct. We could actually change that to being a fuel input, just an input mode like that. And it's set to input mode, and I don't think that's going to make any difference, because I think it's something else that's causing this problem. Yes, the axe still hasn't come in. So I'm going to redesign that between episodes and show you next time.
So until then, bye for now.